Watch closely. I'm going to cut this deck of cards to a random spot. I'm going to take a look at a random card, the Six of Hearts. We're going to take that Six of Hearts and place it in, right, to the pack of cards like so. I mean, look at it. It goes in slow as can be. There's no doubt in your mind. Now watch carefully, all right? We're going to take another card. This is just going to be the top card for right now. That is, of course, the Three of Spades. Now, if you think of your card and you imagine it, we can go like this and we'll make that six appear just like that. A truly astonishing feat indeed. All right, do you like to learn how to do this magic? Well, great. I'm going to show you the resources, all right, that you can use to understand how this is done. Don't worry, I'll teach some of these other tricks later for real, but in this case, I'm going to teach you how you can go and learn much more advanced tricks than this. So, there was a comment on one of my videos that asked, well, where do I start if I want to learn card magic? So this person's obviously new, but today we're going to be discussing a wealth of information that will help both seasoned professionals and those who are also new to learning magic, specifically card magic. But mind you, some of the things I'm going to teach here can be applied to any area of magic, as you will see, and are just very useful techniques for just learning things in general very quickly. Alright, so let's get into this, but before we do, why don't you smash that like button and of course subscribe. You're not going to want to miss all the content that's coming out. Also, I'm going to have links underneath for all the stuff that I mentioned here as resources, so you can go ahead and click those if you're interested in any of them. Let's get into what we're going to be looking at. Now, as for resources, we're going to be talking about one that's online, that's free, that you can use to just understand the fundamental principles and sleights in magic in general, all right? But I want you to keep in mind that if you're going to be learning card magic, it is also important to look through books. It's not, you know, a lot of people are out here buying these new downloads and these things, and those can be great for individual tricks, but if you really want to become a professional, if you really want to learn, accelerate your learning, then you're going to want to get books. And the reason why is they have so much more material. I mean, like, mountains more material for, you know, a lot less of the price. And that's just something to consider. Now, of course, books don't always teach as in-depth or as well as, say, a video tutorial. That's just a fact. They usually don't teach as well. But they do teach a lot more, and they usually have way more routines. And you find a lot of good gems, like good moves that a lot of people just don't know about hidden in books, all right? It's just a fact. You go through a book and you'll find something that no one really uses that just fits you perfectly and just fools the pants off people, all right? So that's something to be aware of. So let's talk about books. Now, a lot of people are aware of Expert at the Card Table, and I would say a lot of people consider it like a holy grail of card magic, and I see that. I understand why. I have read some of this as well. And I've learned, that's where I actually learned some of my, you know, some of the basic techniques of, you know, the second deal and things like that. But here's the thing. There are a lot of other more condensed resources that teach many sleights as well that I think are very important. And so, although Expert at the Card Table is very important, I wouldn't say it's like the end-all be-all. You want to look at a lot of other stuff. So here's some very important ones. This one was one that was brought to me a while ago. That was the Royal Road to Card Magic. It came to my attention. I've seen parts of this book. It's not something that I've thoroughly read, but I'll tell you this, it is very valuable, and everybody that I know that has read it is really good at card magic, and I know a lot of the moves that I personally use have come through the book, even if I didn't originally learn them from there. I learned a lot of them from my magic club or in personal experience of watching people and learning that, right? But I know that they came from that book, and I like to make sure that I know where stuff comes from, so that's the reason why. So, Royal Road to Card Magic, an excellent book. You probably want it if you're learning card magic. I would say it's pretty much a must-have. Now, another one that I am not as familiar with is the Expert Card Technique, all right? Expert Card Technique is different. It's another good, powerful book that has tons of sleights and things like that in it, and you're going to need all this knowledge of all these different sleights in order to, like, really, like, become a master at understanding how to build routines and things like that. That's something I believe. I think it's important to know as many sleights as possible and understand how they work together to create a cohesive type of, you know, performance. So that is another very important book. I personally have not read it in detail, but it's on my list of future books to read. Now, another one is the Encyclopedia of Card Magic. This book is really good, and I wouldn't say it has as many, like, what far out there crazy new stuff in it. Like, I wouldn't say new, because obviously all these things are older, but it doesn't have any kind of, like, wacky, like, crazy ideas that you probably haven't, you know, that's something that you haven't heard of yet. It does have some really powerful stuff, though, in it, and one of my longtime favorite card routines that I do, like, for parties and stuff, actually has some things that came from this book. And that's because I actually originally started learning card magic from that book in a library, because it happened to be in a library where I lived, and I found it, and I started reading it when I was interested in it, and I just read the whole book, and it was pretty good. Now, there's one other book that I want to add to this list that I think you guys would be, or I should say you would find priceless in reading, and that is Drawing Room Deceptions, okay? Drawing Room Deceptions is one of my favorite books of all time, because it has a lot of very interesting card magic in it. And the reason why I think that this card magic is so interesting and unusual is because the techniques are just, they're just different. You see a lot of card magic and it follows the same basic principles and things, but a lot of things in here are just done in a very different and interesting way. And a lot of people would consider it hard, right? But I personally think that a lot of the magic in there isn't as hard as people think it is. It's just people see how complex the thing he's talking about is, and it's just a lot of steps. The steps are easy. There's just a lot of them, right? So it seems overwhelming. But if you spend the time, it's definitely worth it, and I think it's a book that you should check out. Okay, now we're past the books. I know a lot of people are like, oh man, books. Well, let's get into the one resource that you've been waiting for, the free resource, which is probably one of the most important resources that I think anybody should be able or should know about, that everyone should know about when they're learning magic in general. And that is the Conjuring Archive online. I'm sure many of you may already be familiar with it if you're seasoned magicians, but if you're new to magic, I'm sure that you are not aware of it. And this is the Conjuring Archive, all right? So I have the Conjuring Archive pulled up. That's what it's called, conjuringarchive.com, okay? And I have it pulled up in categories. So when it comes up, you're going to want to go to categories. And in categories, it basically has the structure of the Conjuring Archive, which has everything listed by, like, you know, their names and what they're related to. So basically, they're, for cards, if you come down here, I have cards opened up, as you'll see here, if I see it here. Card Magic, let me just check through really quick. I have cards opened up in here, and the coolest thing is that, yes, so here, you can open up sleights. So as you see, it's organized by gaffed cards, jumbo cards, manipulations, principles, props, and sleights. And if you open up sleights, here it has a list of all the different sleights that exist that are famous in the magic world. And so here, you will probably find things that you've never heard of. Well, I guarantee it. Especially if you're new, you're going to find things that you never heard of. And what I recommend doing is going down this list and learning about every single one of the things on this list, all right? Research each thing on this list individually, and then you can even open up a lot of these into their own things, and you'll learn variations on the sleights and different things like that. And by doing this, this will accelerate your learning, because you'll know what you need to learn. You'll know what is out there, all right, and kind of what you need to learn that you may not normally, like, ever come in contact with, because this has it all in one spot, right? So anyways, this here is a perfect example of how we can use the internet and things like this to learn nowadays. Things that, you know, normally would take years, we can do in a very short amount of time. I'll give you examples. The other day, I wanted to learn some move. I think it was on false displays, right? So I came down here, and I just went through some of these. There's one for four of a kind, hiding surfaces and things like that. I just clicked on it, and I learned a new sleight of hand that I never knew because I read the description. And it didn't tell me how to do it, but I was able to look it up and find it, all right, in some other books and things like that, and was able to actually go, wow, interesting. Now I've learned something I didn't know before. So anyways, it's powerful. Some of the stuff on here you can look up on YouTube. People have done demonstrations of it. Some of it you can find talked about in, like, blogs and things like that, or in, you know, some type of forum. And some of it you'll just have to go find the book and read it. But either way, it will show you kind of where you are in the amount of knowledge that you have. You know, if you can come here and see how many of these you can check off, And then you'll know, okay, how well do I know the magic world in general, right? How well do I know card magic as a whole in general? It can help you see that, all right? So anyways, that basically sums up the wonderful resources that are out there to help you really become a proficient card magician. Remember, you have to practice everything. You can't just read books. You have to practice. And practice is super important. So yes, here's the information. Now you're able to understand where to start, but the truth is you're going to have to do the actual work. Now that you've seen it here, you're going to have to set aside time to practice. I love practicing, so I've never had trouble with that. But I know for some people that might be a little difficult. Even though they love to perform it, just getting started on the first, you know, practice run of it can be a little bit difficult. Anyways, I hope this has been helpful. Remember, if you like this material, you want to smash that like button if you haven't already. And of course, you'll want to subscribe. I thank you for your time, and I look forward to seeing you guys again. Remember, the links are down below. You can go ahead and buy any of these books from any of the links down below if you'd like. Remember, by doing so, it helps me out. Also, there's also a link to the Conjuring Archive as well. Again, thanks for your time, and I'll see you again soon.